To the FC debate, the World Cup draw is upon us. Out of the 32 teams, gentlemen, how many can realistically win the tournament?
For me, 5. Brazil, who are my picks to win it all. Germany, Spain, who I think are the next best two teams in world football. I think France, if things go right, I think they would have learned from that experience of losing in the Euro final. And I think Argentina, purely because of the names they have on paper, nothing they've done on the field outside of Lionel Messi's own individual performances suggests as much. But when you look at this team and how stacked it is, if somehow they turn things around and get it right, they have a chance. Nobody else.
I'd add another team to that, and that's Belgium. They've got some good players.
Oh, the dark horses, as always.
Yeah, I think they're starting to become a team. The only thing that could let them down is Roberto Martinez has not had any tournament experience as a player or as a coach, which might, because it is difficult when you're coaching or managing in tournament environment. Will he be able to cope with some of the big egos there? If he can, they've got a good chance of winning.
They could win it though, Gab, couldn't they?
Of course they could, and I'm going to go further. I think we often forget that this is a one-month tournament, and it's a knockout tournament, and a lot of things can go on. I would certainly include England as a team.
Oh, what?
Could, I'm not saying they will, but a team that
Shaka's
that
popping
would
up
win
over
the World
there,
Cup.
This is the same England that had Jermaine Defoe in the squad not that long ago.
Hey, Jermaine Defoe.
And if it were a league, I would agree with you. But it's not. It's a World Cup. So I don't see why it's absurd to say they can win it. And now I'll go even further.
Senegal? Are you going to say them now?
Russia? Are you going to say Russia?
Senegal, France? No.
Iceland. What about Iceland?
I wouldn't rule out. I was actually going to say Senegal. Because when you've got a spine of Koulibaly, Gay, Kouyaté, and Mane up front, that's pretty good. Once you get going, let's not forget Costa Rica last time, where everybody went and giggled at, right? Costa Rica went out in the quarterfinals on penalty kicks to Holland. But that's fine.
They did well.
Not many teams
we're talking about who's going to win.
That's not the question. The question is who can win the World Cup.
Realistically winning.
Yes, I think realistically, these teams aren't beaten. These teams can get hot. If Uruguay get to the quarterfinals and then all of a sudden Suarez and Cavani go on some kind of tear, even Portugal. Crazy as it is.
No, that's crazy.
Okay.
That's what everyone thought at the
crazy.
Euros.
Portugal won the Euros. Let's not forget.
Without winning a game in 90 minutes.
You don't need to. It's the World Cup. I mean, this is how
so
this
how
is
many
how
are you
works.
Saying?
I think you're a bit optimistic.
I'm going to go as high as 11 or 12.
Panama, have they got a chance of that?
You know what? I hope somebody's saving this. No, seriously, I don't think I'm going to win it. But I love this sort of first worldism where like it's going to be the same guys over and over again. Yeah, I know. He's about to run. How funny! He's the greatest hero of the week.
How funny, Stuart.
You know, I'll tell you what.
Yeah.
We got 4 of those at home. Very happy to let the rest of you go and go and fight over the World Cup.
I think you got through the armor there.
Stevie, how many on your list? As Shaka said, 5, 6, 32.
Yeah, I'm with Shaka. I kind of thought about Belgium. And then I thought, you know, Roberto Martinez. Having not had any tournament experience, and I'm not so sure he can sort out a defence either. And you need to defend at a World Cup, so that's why I'll rule them out. But Amushaka has 5.
Sound predictions.
Well, what do you think?
I agree with all of you. I think everybody stands a chance when they go out there. You never know.
Right.
All right. Well, if you ever miss a show,
yep,
you can head on over to ESPNFC.com or subscribe to our podcast on iTunes.